We can represent most things by a list of properties and their values. Think about how you would represent you or your cell phone, the email in your inbox, maybe even events such as the last party you attended. Mostly a list of key value pairs, right? Key value pairs, or dictionaries as they're called in Python, make a lot of sense as a way to represent data, primarily because it's so natural to represent so much of the data we care about this way. Let's think about the you example for a minute. In my case, some of the features might be eyes, brown, hair, brown, height, 6'2", weight. I'll leave that as an exercise for the viewer. Note that name pairs are very different from documents. With a document, we have sections containing subsections, containing paragraphs, containing sentences. This type of nesting or tree structure is exactly the type of structure that XML was designed to work with. In practice, you'll find that XML is used for many purposes, even those for which it's probably not the best choice, and others for which one could argue it's not appropriate. In order to ensure you're ready to wrangle XML in all its forms, we'll give you some practice working with applications of XML to both documents and key value data.